Today's video is really for the people who is looking into life insurance. Should I go for term life insurance? I heard that they are the cheapest form of life insurance. Anything other than that seems extra, more like giving extra profit to the insurance companies. Or if I searched the word term insurance versus permanent ones, my mind was blown by how diversified the comments are. What's worse is many of them are not even correct, but they think they know the whole picture. What should we do then? Hi friends, welcome back to my channel. This is Thomas, your trusted advisor here, and that's what I'm going to share in this video today. The good, the bad, and the ugly side of the term insurance in Canada. I want to give you all the pros and cons about term life insurance. No, I don't just mean term is temporary, where permanent can have the coverage for the entire life. What I'm about to share is something that you don't find elsewhere. I will also give you the average price of term life insurance based on the big four insurance companies in Canada. And lastly, I will put an action plan so you know if term life insurance can cover all your needs. Oh, and for this video, I'll recommend to adjust the speed to 1.25 or 1.5 times, so you get to learn everything in the least amount of time. Let's start with the good. What's so good about term life insurance then? First of all, like I said in the last video, it's the simplest and the cheapest form of all kinds of life insurance. You pay, you get covered. You died, your family gets the money. Simple as that. Term insurance is best at diverting risk during a critical phase. It is the most ideal for people who know exactly what they need or for those who are on a tight budget. Example would be like the mortgage for your new home, a newborn child that you're gonna kick him out when he reaches 18, or the key person in your business. Term insurance in this case is to cover the immediate risk, and that risk has an expiry date. To get a coverage of $500,000 for the next 20 years, I run quotes with the big four insurance companies in Canada. The average cost for a 30-year-old male, non-smoker, will be around $33 per month. Ladies, $24 per month. Why the big difference, in case you ask? The short answer is that females tend to live longer. Sorry, boys. Anyway, it seems like a fair deal, using pennies to exchange for the dollars. And in Canada, both the coverage and the payment are fixed, meaning life insurance company cannot increase the price or adjust the coverage amounts of an old policy. So what's the catch? Well, let's dive into the bad and the ugly then. There are 4 points I want to share. First is what happens when your term insurance ends and yet you still need the coverage. Like instead of 20 years amortization mortgage, now it becomes 30 years. Or your son decides not to move out until he's married. How much does it cost to renew the term life insurance policies by then? Using the previous example, the $33 per month will now jump to $350 per month to cover between the age of 50 to 70. That's 10 times the jump. And if you still need insurance coverage after age 70, no problem. Insurance company have to renew the insurance policy no matter what your health condition is. By then, the cost will jump to $2,000 per month. Also, the term life insurance coverage is usually fixed, meaning no matter you pass away tomorrow or 30 years later, you will only get the same coverage. The problem is that inflation will take most of the money away. With an inflation rate of 2% per year, the $500,000 in the next 30 years will only worth $280,000, versus a permanent life insurance coverage can be indexed, meaning the coverage will increase as time goes. A lot of people will say the best strategy is buy term and invest the difference. And by the time that you're retired, all the debt should be paid off. Therefore, you don't need insurance anymore. Is this true? Let's look back at 2008, where the oil price is at rock bottom. In theory, people pay less in gas, so they have more money to save. But guess what? Most of them just get more expensive gas to compensate for it, because in their mind, those money are meant to be spent. They rather spend it in the restaurant instead of putting in a piggy bank. Also, according to Statistics Canada, 34% of the retired people over the age of 55 are still carrying debt, and this number will increase after the pandemic. Lastly, as I mentioned in the beginning, term insurance is best to cover the immediate risk, but what about long-term risk? For example, when one passes away, there are 2 final tax bills he or she still need to pay. First, in Canada, there's no death tax, but we do have something called the probate fee. We can cover the details about probate in the later videos. In short, roughly you need to pay 1 to 2% fees of your overall assets, depending which province you're in. What's more, you still have to pay a final income tax bill when you're dead. Yep, all the RSP, investment growth, your second, third investment property, and many more will consider as your last year income, and easily, your family have to write a six-figure check to the taxman. If the person lives beyond 80, 85 years old, term insurance in this case will not be able to cover the bill. And the more investment he or she has, the heavier the tax bill will become. The ugly truth is that for term life insurance, if set up for the wrong purpose, can hide a nasty surprise. I have many clients who share with me about their insurance purchase 20 years ago. The sole reason that they bought the term insurance back then was about the low upfront costs. 20 years went by and they still want to keep their coverage, but in order to do so, they must pay 10 times more than before. Now it becomes a heavy burden and they're stuck. That is why the initial step of the plan is critical. Let's do a recap and an action plan whether you should consider a term life insurance only. The cost of a term insurance is very low at the beginning, but it gets very steep when you renew the policy. So list out all the immediate debts and how long will the debts be repaid. By any chance, will these debts gonna be extended? What is the budget that you can allocate? As I mentioned in the last video, the ideal budget for all insurance together should be no more than 10% of your income. What is your shopping mode? Say, when you purchase a car, do you only look for the basic features for cost-wise? Or are you the type that likes to add more features to make the car more valuable? Next is, what are your saving habits? Do you always spend before save, or the opposite? Sometimes you can force yourself to save in a permanent insurance where it can boost your additional retirement savings. Versus for term insurance, there's nothing you can get back at the end. You see, term insurance cannot be the perfect solution to all the questions above. To me, every plan has a purpose. So instead of seeing what is better, I'd rather look at your situation to see which one makes more sense. During the prime time, life insurance will be used as a risk protection tool. But later in life, it will become a wealth transfer tool. I personally have both term and permanent to cover my immediate and long-term risk. Regardless of which insurance you have for you, just know that insurance's main focus is to divert risk. How you want to set it up is depending on your risk factors, and it should be the primary discussion between you and your insurance professional. So please, if you find this video useful, share with them, and tell me more about your experience with your insurance plan in the comment section below. This is Thomas, and thanks for watching. Bye guys!